Welcome back to my channel. My name is Jasmine and today we are going to do plant haul. So this weekend me and my husband went to Ensenal Nursery in Oakland. I have done a plant tour of Ensenal Nursery in the past. It's in Oakland. It's a really beautiful nursery. They have really cool collection at good prices. So for those who are local to the area, go and check it out. So I bought like three plants from them, and then I got another plant from Home Depot. I was basically hunting for Raphidophora tetrasperma in Home Depot. Yeah, like some people have reported they've seen it in LA, like in some of the Home Depots in LA, but I couldn't find one. But I found something else that I'm gonna show you in a minute. But let's get started with Ensenal Nursery. First plant is this Denanthe Burlmax. It's in a 4-inch pot, and I think I paid $12, $12.50, and yeah, it's shooting out new leaves. And I actually got one of these as a cutting from the plant swap that we did, but that's kind of dying. I don't know what happened there, but let's hope this one stays like it is right now. Is a Calathea. Calathea Beauty Star. How full is that? And the leaves are really like thicker than the regular leaves of a Calathea. This is much thicker. And this is in a 6-inch pot, and I paid $25 for this one. Not sure if that's expensive, but I couldn't find it anywhere else, so I kind of splurged on that one. And it has like roots coming out from everywhere, so it's ready to be repotted. Do you like it? You need to tell me your favorite out of all those four in the comments below. Let me know. Next one is also a Calathea, obviously, and this one is Calathea vittata. How cool is that? Look at that one. And this is in a 6-inch pot again, and I think I paid $25 for this as well. It has like new leaves coming. Can you see it over here? And a couple more places. But this is Calathea vittata. If anybody has any of these plants, let me know. I know they are Calathea, so the standard practice is to give them medium light and keep them moist and give them humidity. But if there's anything else that you're doing to keep these plants happy, let me know. And the final plant, so these are the three plants that I got from Ensenal. That's about it. I got some of these bamboo loops as well that I'm using for my Hoya obovata, and then my Adansonia, because they are getting really big and I want them to climb up. So I'm using these for those two plants. I got three of them for $6.99 from the same place, Ensenal Nursery. And the last plant that I got when I was hunting for Raphidophora tetrasperma is this guy over here. This is a Diefenbachia reflector. Leave this cut off. There's a history on that, I'll tell you in a second. And it has like lots of other leaves. And this is quite big. When I got this one, like I would say a week back, it has this leaf that's growing even bigger now. And then it started shooting out another leaf, which if I can find it, I'll show you. Over here, this guy. And so that tells me that this might be like a easy grower. Now the history of it, like the leaves, as you see, is cut from here. The rest of the plant looks good. There were a couple more leaves that were cut from here and there. So I thought, okay, I'll go and talk to the cashier and see if he can give me a discount. And at the time I didn't know the price, because it says nowhere here the price, but I forgot to check over here, and this says $10. I didn't know. I was like, okay, this is a reflector, it's gonna be expensive, so let's ask for a discount. And the guy over there, he's like, yeah, for sure. And then he checked the price, and instead of starting at $10, he started at $6 for some reason. And then he gave me 10% off on that. So I paid $5.89 for this guy. And you know, as soon as I posted on Instagram, someone said that she actually paid $35 for a much smaller version of this guy from somewhere. I don't know where she bought it from. But look at that. It actually reflects, if you can see. And the variation is so much that I kind of want to say that this is aglaonema. What is it? Aglaonema pictum color? Tripictum? Something of that sort. The one that looks like camouflage-y. But I feel this one isn't the same. I think I'm just blabbering right now. I should stop right now. Okay, so these are the four plants that I got over the weekend. I ordered one more plant, like I told you before, and they have not shipped yet. But I'm going out this weekend, and I told them to hold off on the shipment. I told them yesterday because I don't want them to ship it now and then it being sitting in the post box the whole time. So probably once I come back on Monday, probably they can ship it then. So once that arrives, I'll do a unboxing on that, and that's about it. Thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you like it. Give it a big thumbs up if you like it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. And you must have noticed by now, there was no music, only in the beginning and only in the end. So no more loud music. Thanks so much for watching.